Here we are at NASA's Michoud Assembly Facility in New Orleans. This place has an incredible history, everything back from the Apollo, Saturn V, the external tanks for the space shuttle system, and now doing some really incredible things with the space launch system, which would be the Artemis program to the moon, and the Orion capsule looking at deep space, maybe even taking that capsule to Mars. So it's amazing seeing this facility continue to play a leading role in the NASA program and our future space exploration programs.
Well, we're incredibly proud of Michoud's history, but with nearly 2 million square feet of manufacturing facility here, Michoud's able to attract the world's best aerospace technology companies like Boeing and Lockheed Martin, and they've created over 5,000 jobs of people who are delivering the next generation of space exploration for America and for NASA.
Thank you. What an awesome facility this is to be able to come over here to my neighbor. I'm from Texas, represent Johnson Space Center, but to be able to come over and see the Michoud facility and see what's happening in this huge, huge operation where 5,000 people are employed. And I'll tell you, to turn around and look at the size of this SLS rocket, it's awesome. And I would invite you to come into my office in Washington, D.C., and in the Rayburn office building and look on the wall. We have models of two big SLS rockets, and we're real proud of it. And we know that this is going to be the avenue for us to go back to the moon and on to Mars after that. And I'm very proud to be leading the SLS and Orion letter each year, where we have a number of our colleagues get to sign on. And because this is so important for us to maintain our number one position as a spacefaring nation, and that's where we want to stay, and we don't want to lose that position. So thank you.
It's amazing, this technology, what it delivers, but this is the future of space exploration, starting right here at Michoud.
So from cuisine to space, Louisiana and NASA just taking us to the next generation.
Yeah, because what they're doing right here in Michoud is also feeding the things that go into all the rest of our NASA facilities. And as the ranking member of the Space and Aeronautics Subcommittee, I'm just really proud to see this assembly and how it works. Some of these things are going over to Marshall and on over to the Kennedy Space Center. And really is good to be here in your neck of the woods, both of you guys, letting a Texan come over here and visit your districts.
You're always welcome over here. And look, we're all proud, Texas, Louisiana, Florida, all the states that are involved in NASA's mission, because when you think about the decades that Michoud here in New Orleans has been involved in the state space program, there are so many states involved in this. And it's something that really, I think, gives inspiration to the people in the country. When they see a rocket going up and hopefully going to the moon and then to Mars, it's going to re-galvanize people and encourage more people to go into those core STEM technologies like science, like math, engineering. And that's what we need more of in America. And I think NASA's been one of those great drivers of the program. We're proud of the Michoud role that's been played in our space program.
Elise was mentioning, this isn't just about Louisiana and Texas and all the Gulf Coast NASA and space facilities, but there are 1,100 suppliers across the continental United States that are providing resources to make all of this work and connecting it all. As you can see, just the huge size of these components that are behind us. That right there alone is over 120 feet long.
Because what you just said, there are 5,000 employees here. This is kind of a microcosm of what's going on in our whole space program. Out of the 5,000 employees here, very few actually are federal civil servants. These are commercial workers. These are people in the private space industry, the commercial industry that is making all of this possible and creating literally hundreds of thousands of jobs and spinoffs. And as I said, keeping us the number one spacefaring nation.